Well, Dave, thank you for joining me here at the conference. As you all know, Dave's the product manager of our beautiful Alliance IS system here. And Dave, what I wanted to do, I know people are well aware of the system, but let's start back from the beginning. What or who inspired this beautiful system?
You know, it's a great question, Ronak. And, you know, in all honesty, we've had such success with our legacy Alliance system. We then wanted to bring the next tier of an instrument into our portfolio. We believe we've done that with the Alliance IS. Based upon information we've been hearing from our customers, we'd hit the mark. We're expecting that the demand for this will be as robust, if not more, than what the original Alliance was when we first started this 30 some odd years ago.
But tell me something a little bit about this design.
First and foremost, you can't help but be drawn to not only the colors, the industrial design, but the way in which we've integrated a 10-inch touchscreen command center, if you will, as well as the bottle tray on top, has really been the differentiation. We wanted to keep with the same kind of integrated theme that the original Alliance had, and we built that in here. One of the things that we really wanted to focus in on was understanding from the customers, from the users, what are the pain points? What's the most irritating thing that occurs to you as you're setting up an instrument? Now, we all recognize that instruments will fail or have issues or problems from time to time, but we really wanted to focus in on what we could do to prevent a lot of that stuff. So in combination with global interviews that we would have with multiple amounts of customers, we then started to put together charts, Pareto or otherwise, and just capture this information and try and line up what was the most issues or problems, where could we make a difference? What I like to call it is it's an intuitive way for our own internal intelligence, if you will. So we actually understood that we can minimize up to about 40% of basic human errors just by alerting the customer that something may not go right, and we've done that.
Yeah, so tell me a little bit about the bottle tray.
Since that's the next question, the bottle tray is fantastic. Now, what we're not seeing right now is an illumination of the glass. And there's a glass barrier that's right here that's pressed into the tray, so no issues or problems if there was a spill or a leak. But the benefit associated with that crystal glass is there's a colored hue depending upon the nature of the operation of the instrument itself. As an example, when it's getting ready to operate and run, it turns a blue hue. If it's operating and running and collecting chromatography, if you will, it's turning a hue green. If there's an issue, a problem, a concern, or a failure, it actually turns red. So lab managers from afar can look at the instruments that are within their benches and they can say, this one's operating very well, this one here has a health-related issue, and they'll get a good feel for what it is that needs attention. It's the one biggest thing that most of our users focus in on, and they love the touchscreen, they love the bottle tray.
So that speaks a lot to intuitive design, and frankly, that's what I've noticed myself on the system, which is what I really, really like. Now, you mentioned a lot of these color schemes, and something that caught my eye was right here on the side, color-coded system. Can you talk a little bit about that?
And one of the biggest issues, problems that most scientists have or personnel in the laboratory is what we would call the spaghetti aspect associated with the solvent lines. They typically bend or kink, or there's too much line. They coil up and they're usually in everybody's face, or they're usually all over the place. We were purposefully making sure that we could address those lines. As you pointed out, we have some flags that are along the side that address the tubing. It keeps the tubing nice and tight against the side. Equally important is what we've done to the bottle caps. If you focus in on the top, we also have the letters for the bottle caps, A, B, C, and D. The bottle cap is quite unique. It rotates all the way around, so the tubing never ever starts to kink or get tied up.
That's amazing. I mean, that is quite the innovation that is seemingly simple, but actually drives a lot of value for our customers. And even as I was going around the globe, it's certainly something that people pointed out. You talked about the design, right, and alerting users. Tell me a little bit about this touchscreen here. Tell me a little bit more.
From the touchscreen itself, you could start to set up your entire method, the method development that you have. You can download a method, you can create your own method, you can start your pump, and you can identify as you typically would with an Empower screen, and you still will use that anyways. But this, the touchscreen will follow every unique command that has been provided, either through the Empower software and or the way in which that you want to program from the front screen. So it gives everybody that firsthand knowledge of being able to operate right with the touch itself. And after all, with everybody as used to it as they are with iPhones today and the keypad, we at the same time wanted to mimic what we could do here.
That's great. And you know, that design simplicity, that intuitive design that people are used to really helps people get up to speed. You know, one of the things that I hear all the time is about how science is changing, right? And for me, that intuitive design becomes important. And I think you alluded to that quite well. Tell me about what it took to build the system, right? So you're in the weeds day in and day out with our engineers, our scientists, our user experience design team, our content team, you name it. There's a lot of groups that are involved. Our marketers, our product management team. What did it really take? I'm sure it was only a few hours. Just kidding.
I've had the pleasure of being on many new product announcements and new product introductions. This part has involved probably more functional groups and teams than I had ever been worked with in the past, but in such a very collaborative way. In working from an ideation aspect and then trying to understand what we would do from an alpha build and then progressing up through a beta build, working with our evaluation teams, working with our engineering team, working with our content completed different departments, it took a village. I mean, it was multi-year, but the end result was ensuring that we hit it right. We wanted to design and develop an instrument that really was designed by the folks that participated in a lot of those interviews that we created. We did not want to build an instrument and say, this is what you need. They instead told us what they needed. We believe we've done that. All the functional groups and teams have done their testing, their verification, the validation. We're quite confident, not only in the operation, but the overall, I have to say, giant success that I'm expecting from this.
That's certainly great. And we're already seeing a lot of great excitement and momentum. So let's talk about why we're here today. What excites you about us being here today at the HPLC conference?
You know, this gives us yet another opportunity to exploit what the Alliance IS is. And as we indicated, IS, intuitive simplicity. That's the whole purpose aspect of what the development and design of this instrument will be. This week in particular, we're now doing what we would call kind of a phase two or version two. Why? Because now we've got an integrated system that houses a PDA, photodiode array detector, which provides increased capability for the scientist or lab specialist that's going ahead and running an assay. We will continue to keep up, you know, with the demand and the pace from our customers and what they're looking for. We have TUV today as a standing instrument. We have the TUV Bio HPLC system, and now we have the PDA photodiode array Alliance IS HPLC system. We're continuing to move forward, we're continuing to innovate, and I think we've hit the nail on the head here.
And I loved your comment around the continual innovation that we at Waters are bringing to the market. And just to reinforce that point, I mean, I think you've said this already, but just so customers know, is this it, or should we expect more?
One thing that occurs at Waters, and you know, consider it the culture, is we're never satisfied. You know, we're continuing to always make improvements, continuing to make updates. What we have today, we know has certainly at least met what the overall expectations had been from what users want from us. We want to exceed that. As we continue to exceed it, we'll bring in additional innovations. We'll look at different ways in which to work with the injector, different ways to work with serviceability, capability of the pump, different ways to work with what we've got for the column heater cooler. RFID technology is something new to Waters. We're doing that now. People love it. Cordless capabilities for the column, being able to read all the information. Little things like that, but they're giant steps for what users and customers were looking for. We want to keep up with everything that's going on, and we will continue with phase three, phase four, phase five. We will not stop.
That's great to hear. And you referenced you've been around a lot of product launches at Waters. Now, I won't ask you how long you've been at Waters, but let me ask you this. Of everything you've seen here at Waters, Yes. This clearly stands out in your mind. What's the one thing that you want people to take away?
I want people to recognize that the amount of work that went into this incident was done purposefully to ensure that we addressed what those issues and concerns were for most of the users and customers. This was a completely identified for the QA/QC market. Not only are we making giant inroads into this market, we're continuing to push the boundaries out even further. We'll continue to capture that. I think in combination with some of the launches that I've had the privilege of being a part of, this in and of itself motivates me more because it's continuous operation, right answer, right time, all the time, every time.
That's awesome.
Well, with that, I don't know that I can say much more. Dave, I thank you very much for your time. And for those out there that are listening to us today, I want to say that the Alliance IS family, it's a system that's designed and made for you, as Dave articulated. It's a system that we've put our heart and souls into. So thank you very much, Dave. I really appreciate the time. And thank you all for listening.
Thank you.